Hi everyone, welcome back to Wesnow's Tech News and Reviews. Today we're going to be doing a test, an accuracy test of the new Xiaomi Mi Band 6 versus the Amazfit Bip U right here. So we've done a comparison versus the Honor Band 6 of the Mi Band 6, and the results were very good. As in, both the Honor Band 6 as well as the Xiaomi Mi Band 6 has shown that they are very accurate indeed. So we've taken the other contender now from the Amazfit camp, because the Amazfit Bip U is also a contender of the Mi Band 6. It's in the same price segment. In fact, both are under 40 bucks. Now the accuracy test was done with the help of the Polar H10 ECG chest strap that was used as the benchmark heart rate. So without further ado, let's get into the details.
If you are new to Wesnow's Tech News and Reviews, we talk about the latest tech news. We do brutally honest reviews and share hacks and tricks along the way.
And now, in order to set the scene, let me tell you about how we actually performed this accuracy test. So first of all, I went to the gym, because finally the gyms are open in the UK, and I've done a 25-minute workout. So for the first 10 minutes, I was on the treadmill. So I ran for about a kilometer and a half, so just under 1 mile. And you can see that from the plot of the H10 or the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. As you can see, the heart rate was gradually increasing until it reached a peak of 180 beats per minute. Then we can see the drop in the heart rate, because as I stepped off the treadmill, I walked over to the weight section, because in between doing the sets on the bench press, I was actually doing squats as well as exercises for the core and for my abs. So you can see on the plot of the Polar H10, as the heart rate was actually increasing in spikes and in steps up. So what we're going to be doing in this particular test is we're going to be taking the plot from the Polar H10 ECG chest strap, and on top of that plot we'll be putting in the heart rate plots from the Mi Band 6 as well as the Amazfit Bip U. Now before we get into the numbers, let's do a quick recap of what these bands actually bring to you, the user. Let's start off with the Mi Band 6. So this is the all-new tracker that was released globally on the 2nd of April this year, 2021. Now I'm sure that's not out in many of the countries across Europe, US, even Asia, but I have managed to get mine under 35 bucks, and I got it from AliExpress. Now delivery did take only a couple of days, well it was about a week actually, but it's here and it's much cheaper than I could get it from Amazon UK, because on Amazon UK you can get it for £58, and that's quite a bit more, that's about 50% more. Anyway, let me tell you about this tracker here. So of course it is waterproof up to 50 meters. You can pop it out easily from its strap, and you can change your straps to any color you want. So this is a TPU strap, and it's basically the tuck and clip type clasp. Nothing really changed from the Mi Band 5. It's still just as convenient and easy to use. What has changed in the sport modes, instead of just having 11 sport modes, there are 30. You can't expand it anymore, it's just the 30, but really, that's more than enough on such a budget tracker. Also, instead of the two auto-recognized activities which we used to see on the Mi Band 5, there's now 6 auto-detected activities. And that is really awesome. And you can set which activities you want the watch to be able to auto-detect right from the watch face. And you do that to save battery life, because you don't want the auto detection to work all the time and across exercises that you wouldn't be usually doing. Of course, that's not the only things that were changed or updated on the tracker. Another really awesome feature with the Mi Band 6 is what we were missing on the Mi Band 5, and why it lost, well, in most of our comparisons and tests versus the Honor Band 6 as an example. The fact is, the Mi Band 5 did not have goal-based activities. Yes, you did have your auto pause options, and you did have your pace alerts, so you can set a certain pace you want to run at. You can actually set your heart rate zones or preferable heart rate zones where you want to work out in, but there was no goal-based activities. What does that mean? So by goal-based, that means that before you start, let's say your run, you can actually set how many calories you want to burn during that exercise, or you want to do an exercise for a particular duration, say 30 minutes or an hour. also, if your preferred activity is a run, you can actually set your distance, let's say 5K run or 10K run, and the watch will vibrate and let you know that you've done the distance. So that is goal-based. And the Mi Band 6 actually has it right now. Other major benefits of the Mi Band 6 is the screen, the display. As you can see, the Mi Band 6 kept its traditional tracker look, so the slimline design. So this is not the Honor Band 6, neither is the Amazfit BPU. It looks like a tracker, like any other tracker. But instead of the huge plastic face and in the middle just a small AMOLED display, the AMOLED display stretches edge to edge. And that is amazing. 1.56 inches of AMOLED display, 450 nits of brightness right here. So it's bright, you can see the screen in any light conditions, and there's no issue with reading texts, reading any stats and metrics off the watch face while you're doing your exercises. Anyway, let's have a chat about the Amazfit BPU before we look at the numbers. Now, the Amazfit BPU is also a tracker that has a lot of background and a lot of history. If you recall, it all started with the BIP a couple of years back. Then we had the BIP S. So now the BIPU is a great update to all those trackers because finally it's got a really sharp color LCD display. It's also quite large, it's more square, so it's not as elongated, and it looks more like a smartwatch rather than a fitness tracker. It's got a lot to offer. It's got 70 sport modes. Now, 70 sport modes is a lot. As we recall in the Mi Band 6, there's just 30, here's the 70. Also, both of these trackers do not have inbuilt GPS, they have connected GPS. So you do need your smartphone in order to calculate your distance, your speed, and so on. Now, this one is also waterproof. In regards to the strap, everything is more like a watch on the BIPU as well. So as you can see, it's got a replaceable strap. So the usual 20 millimeter generic straps, and you can buy a lot of these from third parties. You can click them on. You want leather, you can get that. You want metal, you can do that as well. So there's a lot of options with the BIPU in regards to the strap. Another really cool thing about the strap is that it does have the classic watch type clasp, which is just so easy and so handy. In regards to the features and functions, I do think that the BIPU has a bit more of that. So it's got a world clock. The Mi Band 6 also has a world clock. Both of the trackers have SpO2, continuous stress monitoring. Both of these trackers can monitor your sleep in three stages. So your light, your deep, and REM sleep. You've got continuous heart rate monitoring. Both of these trackers offer a lot of the core functionality, such as your timer, your stopwatch, your weather widgets, and a lot of advanced functionalities as well as health functionality. Another major benefit with the Amazfit BPU as well as the Xiaomi Mi Band 6 is that they are both under the Xiaomi group, and hence both have Pi. So what's Pi? Pi is the Personal Activity Index. And this Personal Activity Index is a very smart tool. It's a single value which tells you all about your cardiovascular health. And as long as you keep that value above 100 points, it means that in general, you're 25% less prone to getting heart disease. Now, both of these trackers also offer breathing apps, so something to either relax or to work on your breathing. There are a lot of apps and widgets in both of these watches, and that makes it so much fun to use. So it's not smartwatch style, but it's close enough there. I think the biggest difference between the Xiaomi Mi Band 6 and the BIPU is in the screen. So here you've got a 1.4 inch LCD display, while on the Mi Band 6 you've got a 1.56 inch, which is not square but rather a rectangular shape, but it's AMOLED. So these are the biggest differences between the two trackers. Anyway, now let's take a look at the numbers. So let's have an understanding of what the Polar H10 ECG chest strap actually measured. And we can see that as we go through the whole plot, we can see an average heart rate of 151 beats per minute, while the max, and that was reached during the end of the run, is 180 beats per minute. Now, if we put the plot of the Mi Band 6 on top of the Polar H10, we see quite a bit of accuracy. Now, if we take a look at the Mi Band 6 heart rate plot, we can see that the average heart rate is 142 beats per minute, while the max is also 180 beats per minute. So if we look at the variance, we've got an understatement on the average of 9 beats per minute, while on the max, there is no difference. There is no variance. It's on the dot. So where is the issue? Where has most of this understatement happened? And we can see that during the run, everything is tracked quite accurately. We don't see major issues. We don't see any issues when the heart rate is falling as we walk away from the treadmill. We start having problems in the last 5 minutes of the exercise when we see this drastic decrease in heart rate, and it's actually quite a number of beats per minute under those registered by the Polar H10. Now, I'm not sure why that happened, but we will see a very similar picture when we look at the BPU heart rate plot. Nonetheless, we can see that the average was mostly understated because of the lower heart rate registered by the Mi Band 6 as opposed to the Polar H10 in the last 4 or 5 minutes of my activities with the weights and the exercises for the core. The BPU has also shown us quite sensible results. We can see that the average is 140 beats per minute, while the max is 175 beats per minute. So understatement across the board, but we can see where it happened as well. So the understatement of the troughs and the peaks actually also occurred in the last 4 to 5 minutes of the activities. But the understatement of the BPU was larger than on the Mi Band 6, and hence the average was even lower. The tracing is rather smooth and in line with what we see on the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. Now, if we look at the max though, it is not as close as the Mi Band 6. It's only 175 beats per minute. So we can see that the max heart rate was also cut off by the BPU. So the peak was underestimated by 5 beats per minute. So 175 versus the 180. Now let's take a holistic view. Let's make a summary of what these two trackers have actually shown us. I think that if we take the first 20 minutes of the activity, of the full 25, these two trackers were tracing the Polar H10 ECG chest strap very closely. Most of the issues or the understatements are occurring in the last 5 minutes. The difference between the Polar H10 max and the BPU max is 5 beats per minute. So once again, the overall result is better on the Mi Band 6. I personally really enjoy the look of the Mi Band 6. I think it's so contemporary. Now that it got rid of that big black face, it looks absolutely amazing. Anyways, I do hope that you enjoyed this test and comparison. If you have, then please drop us a like. And if you want to see more of the same, you know what to do. Please click the red subscribe button below the video, and I'll see you in the next one.